Matt Waymire alongside Dan Rosen as we kick off 31 teams in 31 days with the addition of a new franchise in the NHL. And today, a look at the Anaheim Ducks, the five-time defending Pacific Division champions. They fell to Nashville in six games in the Western Conference Final. And Dan, for a team that, like I said, came within two wins of going back to the Cup Final. Not a lot of noise in the offseason. What do you make of that?
I make that they still think they're a pretty good team, a playoff team, and they didn't want to change a lot, but they did make, to me, some notable additions, certainly in Ryan Miller coming in as the backup goaltender to John Gibson on a two-year contract. Miller, as we know, has been a number one goaltender for his entire career, and now he's accepting of the backup role, which is interesting, and he should be at least as good, if not better, than Jonathan Bernier was as the backup to Gibson last season. And the other addition is under the radar. It's Dennis Rasmussen. He's a one-year deal, but he's a 6'3" power forward, Rasmussen. And he fits right into the Ducks mold as a big team, a power forward team. He's going to play a bottom six role or even be scratched at times, but at 6'3", he fits right in. The notable subtraction to me is Shea Theodore, but remember, they wanted to keep Sammy Vatanen and Josh Manson away from the Vegas Golden Knights in the expansion draft. To do that, the price to pay was Shea Theodore going to Vegas to ensure that Vegas would then take Clayton Stoner and his $3.25 million contract off of the Ducks' hands. So Vegas gets Shea Theodore, they take Stoner, but Anaheim keeps Manson and Vatanen, two guys they obviously value more than Shea Theodore.
The expansion draft made things interesting this summer for many teams, Anaheim included, to say the least. And Dan, there were two pretty significant in-house moves in the offseason, one involving a guy who's been a career Duck, another involving a guy who was a major trade acquisition.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're talking about Cam Fowler, the career Duck. Fowler has one more year left at $4 million on his current contract, and he signed an eight-year contract extension worth $6.5 million annually. So obviously, they value him as part of their core. Remember, there was talk a little while ago of Fowler potentially being traded. Well, not anymore. He signed that eight-year extension. And the other guy is Patrick Eves, who came in, and Patrick Eves was very good. Signed a three-year contract before he could become an unrestricted free agent. Eves scored 11 goals in 20 games after arriving from Dallas, had 32 goals total last season. And the hope, obviously, with Anaheim is he can kind of recreate that over the next couple of seasons.
2 years ago, this Anaheim power play, number one in the NHL this past season, kind of fell off a cliff. Only 17th at 18.7%. Dan, if they want to get back to that elite status on the power play, a lot of it hinges on a guy who's a former Hart Trophy winner.
Yeah, Corey Perry. Corey Perry's got to get back to scoring the way Corey Perry can. He scored 39.4 goals per game in the previous five full NHL seasons. That's not counting the lockout season, the 2012-13 season. Last year, 19 goals. So he obviously has to get back to scoring the way he used to score. If he's going to be a teens scorer, he's going to score in the teens or even the low 20s, going to put a lot of pressure on some other guys. But if he can get back to that 30s, it takes some pressure off of guys like Rickard Rakell and Patrick Eves to score. It boosts their power play. It makes them a better team.
I think we both agree this Anaheim team is going to be a postseason team. But in terms of the Western Conference pecking order, where do they fall now?
Well, it's interesting because I think in years past, we would say they're an absolute lock, stamp them in. But with the emergence of Edmonton and Calgary, I don't think it makes them an absolute lock, especially in that Pacific Division. I still think they're a top four team in that division. I think that they will be a playoff team. But that top four in that division, and I look right now at Anaheim, San Jose, Calgary, and Edmonton as the top four, it's going to be tight. So Anaheim can finish fourth. Anaheim could finish first. I think it's going to be a very tight gap, but they will make the playoffs.